Hello and welcome to yet another exciting video that we have titled Project Pool. In this episode, I am thrilled to share with you some fascinating insights and details about our project. This time, I would like to delve deeper into the various aspects and elements that make this project truly unique and captivating. I mean to get my solar absorbers in order with EPDM mats and eliminate the winter damage. And I recorded the whole thing on video again to show it to one or another, to give a useful tip or hint. If it helps, I am of course even more pleased. After I basically put the pool into operation last week, it has now become clear that some damage has occurred to my solar absorbers over the winter. In particular, a marten seems to have bitten into one of my mats, which means there are holes in it. I would like to patch the mat, and while I'm at it, you'll also see how my piping has become deformed. This is simply because I, in between, had a problem with a valve, which prevented the water from draining. 4.5 bar pressure was exerted on the pipes and the mats, which of course stretched them extremely. Today I want to restore these deformations to order and completely replace a defective mat. Replace and repair another mat. I have safely and completely turned off the power supply to the pool. And I will now basically and essentially just simply take the solar absorbers out of the very frame, and specifically these two items here in the image. The first one that you can see in the picture is completely fine, and I need to explain further about its condition and why it is considered to be in a satisfactory state. This is important because change absolutely nothing. But with the other two, I definitely noticed the very clearly damaged areas indeed during the operation. Marked. You can see well here how the water is standing in the mats. At this, the mat will not need any repairs for now, because the connection pieces at which the are currently stable. Hoses attached to the adapters are currently leaking. I will completely and thoroughly dismantle this mat and... In my workshop, I try to glue or secure these connections. The problem is that due to the fact that with rising water pressure at these specific points, it is observed that on 5 or 6 of the hoses, water is leaking, and not just a little, but it results in a significant amount of water, which is unexpected and unwanted, waterfall. So I will completely remove this mat and replace it with a replacement mat. On my second system, unfortunately, an animal has severely damaged my mats, which is very noticeable here. Good. A considerable number of small bite marks. Since my system is already in operation, and I don't want to unnecessarily and consistently. To prevent water from leaking, I simply used a screw with 2 washers. To seal the damaged area in order to completely, water is still running through just a little bit more, but the great loss has been stopped. I would like this intermediate piece. Now completely replace it. For this I need a piece of hose that I will take from another. I have a mat left, as well as connectors, to join the intact piece of hose with the replacement piece. Connect. I currently do not have these connectors in stock, so I will be the... Installation will take place in the next few days, and the video will be provided afterwards. I think that I can help one or the other with similar problems. Today I will already begin with a part of the solar system, that is a good 2 meters, to dismantle and install the mat on the neighboring solar system. This process involves careful handling and precision to ensure that the mat is properly dismantled and installed in the neighboring solar system. The defective component of this mat requires special attention to detail during the installation process. Has been there longer and is exposed to the sun earlier, the effectiveness is at this side is considerably more higher. On the other hand, additionally, I have the problem that on this solar system, which is currently, and furthermore, experiencing issues, still works, as it is shaded by a tree, when the tree is fully leafed in midsummer, is, I have no sun from about 3 to 4 p.m. anymore, which makes the solar system no longer effective, is working. Therefore, I will rearrange a part of this solar system to address the defect on one side. Repair, and at the same time utilize the possibilities of the other side more effectively. First, I will very carefully remove the cable ties that securely hold the components together, and then, you can clearly see here. It's already very good that the cable ties have suffered in the sun over the years. I can simply pull them out since the heads are already torn off. Here too. It's the same game. The cable ties are not UV resistant and slightly crumble. In the bright and warm sun, which is shining beautifully, I will carefully and meticulously remove this piece, mount the mat securely and firmly on the other side, and seize the opportunity to thoroughly remove all the fallen leaves, accumulated dirt, and debris from the area. This is an essential step to ensure that the systems are meticulously cleaned and maintained. By doing so, you will prevent potential blockages and ensure the smooth operation of the systems, which is crucial for their longevity and efficiency. I have already pulled out the first component. It is simply easiest to do this. When the cable ties are torn, one does not need to try with a screw. You can push them down instead of pulling them out, and then pull out the cable ties on both sides. The second half is still connected. However, by gradually and carefully moving this particular component back and forth in a controlled manner, it is possible to loosen it without much difficulty. This method ensures that the component can be adjusted. In addition to the tasks already mentioned, it is crucial to thoroughly inspect the seals during this particular occasion. The seals, often made of rubber or similar materials, play a vital role in ensuring the integrity and proper functioning of the equipment. Over time, these rubber components can become worn out, cracked, or even completely degraded due to exposure to various environmental factors such as temperature fluctuations, moisture, and chemical interactions. Therefore, it is essential to carefully examine each seal for any. Over the years, the material has gradually become porous, which is clearly visible from the numerous small cracks that have appeared on its surface. I remember when I initially bought these rubber items, they were in perfect condition, without any signs of wear or damage. I bought some at the hardware store, as it is an art to get replacement parts for these solar mats. The mats themselves can be found in any well-stocked pool shop or hardware store, but even here it often applies. The principle? Buy new items instead of repairing them. However, that is not my ultimate objective. I truly want to. To start, gently remove the protective mat from its position. Then, proceed to detach the mounting rails, which are specifically designed to hold the mats securely in place, ensuring they remain stable and unaffected by various. In the process of disassembling the equipment, I have carefully removed the mounting rails, which are essential components that hold various parts in place, to ensure that these crucial screws, which are used to secure the rails, do not get misplaced or lost during the disassembly or reassembly process. I have taken the precaution of storing them in a safe and secure location. This step is vital, because losing even a single screw could lead to difficulties in reassembling the equipment correctly, potentially affecting its functionality. Therefore, by organizing and storing the screws properly, I am ensuring that the reassembly process will be smooth and efficient, with all necessary components readily available and in their proper places. Get lost! I have carefully and meticulously reinserted each and every one of the screws back into their original and respective old holes, since there were indeed some located underneath. A welding strip, which is currently situated on top of a sturdy wooden board, and I really want to avoid any unnecessary new holes in it. At this point, I'm going to carefully dismantle the mats, which involves separating each section with precision. Once that is done, I will proceed to roll them up neatly, ensuring that they are compact and easy to store. Afterward, the mats, which were covered in dust and dirt, were thoroughly swept clean, and the leaves, which had accumulated over time, were carefully washed down using a high-pressure water hose to ensure every last bit of debris was removed. After completing the initial task, I proceeded to carefully flip each of the mats over, one by one, ensuring that I did not miss any spots. Once the mats were turned, I noticed a significant amount of dirt and debris that had accumulated underneath them over time. I took the time to thoroughly remove all the dirt, using a small brush to get into the... A lot of dirt and dust had gradually accumulated over time, which negatively impacted the overall performance and efficiency of the system. This side of the system has currently been in operation for 3 years, and I have never cleaned it this thoroughly and meticulously before in the past. This should really be done at least annually, ideally. After I meticulously cleaned every single component, ensuring that each part was free from any dust, dirt, or debris, I carefully reassembled the mats. This involved a thorough process where I first laid out all the pieces in an organized manner. I then proceeded to wipe down each mat with a specialized cleaning solution designed to remove any stubborn stains or marks. Once the cleaning was complete, I allowed the mats to air dry completely to prevent any moisture from being trapped. Following this, I began the reassembly process, which required aligning each mat precisely to ensure a perfect. I will now carefully, thoroughly, and meticulously examine if everything is sealed. I have reattached the support rails and the mats, which are designed to withstand harsh conditions, have been made wind and weatherproof. Now, the initial trial run is set to take place, during which I will thoroughly test the entire system to ensure its effectiveness and reliability. To initiate the process, I begin by carefully filling the designated container with water. This step is not merely about adding water. It requires a keen attention to detail to ensure that the water level is precisely appropriate. An incorrect water level could lead to spillage, which might cause complications later in the process. The significance of this step cannot be overstated, as it lays the groundwork for all subsequent actions. Once the container is filled to the desired level, I proceed to meticulously inspect every seal and joint. This inspection is a critical phase, as it confirms that all components are intact and functioning correctly. It involves a thorough examination of each part to ensure there are no leaks or weaknesses that could compromise the system's integrity. After confirming that everything is sealed properly, I move on to the next crucial step, which involves pressing out the air from the mats. This is achieved by applying gentle yet firm pressure, ensuring that all air pockets are eliminated. The removal of air is essential for the mats to function as intended, providing the necessary support and stability. Throughout this process, I remain vigilant and attentive to detail, as any oversight could lead to potential issues. By diligently following these steps, I ensure that the system is prepared and ready for use, with all components functioning optimally and securely. This comprehensive approach guarantees that the system will perform as expected, providing reliability and peace of mind. The entire procedure is a testament to the importance of precision and care in ensuring that every aspect of the system is in perfect working order, ready to deliver the expected performance without any hitches. Additionally, I take the time to double-check each step, ensuring that no detail is overlooked. This includes revisiting the water level to confirm it remains stable, and re-inspecting the seals and joints for any signs of wear or potential failure. The process of pressing out the air from the mats is repeated as necessary to ensure complete air removal, as even the smallest air pocket can affect the mat's performance. By maintaining a methodical and thorough approach, I can confidently prepare the system for its intended use knowing that every component has been checked and rechecked for optimal functionality. Furthermore, I document each step meticulously, noting any observations or adjustments made during the process. This documentation serves as a valuable reference for future maintenance and ensures that the system's setup can be replicated with the same level of precision and care. By adhering to this detailed and comprehensive procedure, I ensure that the system is not only ready for immediate use, but also primed for long-term reliability and efficiency. Currently, as we observe the surroundings, it is important to note that there are no water fountains available in this area. This observation is crucial because it indicates that everything is functioning as expected and there are no unexpected issues or anomalies present. The absence of water fountains suggests that the infrastructure is either still under development or intentionally designed this way, possibly due to specific planning or environmental considerations. Therefore, based on the current assessment, everything appears to be in order and aligned with the intended design or operational plan. Unfortunately, it has been clearly shown that on the specific tracks that I personally installed, but several damages were present. For this reason, I decided to address the mats that are repairable or still intact, to be removed from the third solar field and to integrate into the other two. This way, I can calmly repair the third solar field or rebuild. In the second solar field, I have now done the following. I have also worked on the system here. First dismantled, the substrate is carefully and thoroughly cleaned, and then the replacement part is reinstalled. So, what I was planning to do anyway, to replace the defective part. Additionally, I have installed another field from the third solar field here. The system is therefore further improved, moved up and down. The whole setup is now more in the sun than before, and the third solar field is getting more sunlight, boosting its effectiveness.